Assalamualaikum viewers, thank you very much for the subscription of my channel and watching my videos. I am extremely grateful to you for this kind act. And before you view this video, those who have not subscribed my channel, please push the subscription button and subscribe this channel to get the latest updation related to the psychology and the various other subjects. Today the topic under discussion is that is body shaming, and I am sure that majority of the people are not aware about this term because this is not commonly used, and this is basically a negative behavior and a negative comment and a mockery comment towards the other person on the basis of their body shapes and body size. This is very common among the adolescents. For example, we must have seen that in every campus, in every university, in all the institutions, there are some of the students, or a few students, who are either overweight or underweight. So those who are overweight, they are the direct victim by their peer group, and they are passing the negative comments to their peer group because they would be saying, oh, look at your size, you are a big joint. So this is the negative comment, and they are passing the negative comments, and mockery behavior is being showed toward them, and they make fun of them and they enjoy themselves. But we also need to see how the person would be feeling who is the direct victim of these things. It leads towards anxiety, it leads toward the stress toward that person, and this comment word will stick to the mind of that person who is the subject of it. And if they are frequently facing all those comments by their peer group, then it would be leading towards the prolonged anxiety and stress, which can lead towards the various psychological minor disorders. So we can also say that body shaming is also related to the eating disorder. How it is related to the eating disorder? Because there are few adolescents who are overweight, are underweight, and they are anorexic or bulimic. Those who are bulimic, they will be eating a lot. And while eating a lot, they will never think about their overweight and that they are gaining the weight. And with the passage of the time, a time will come when they will be looking so much fat and obese and chubby. So this is the first step. Without knowing it, they become obese. Anorexic nervosic are those people who leave eating and they become underweight. If there is some person, there is some adolescent who is underweight and he or she is not growing according to the dietitian and according to the medical history, then that person is, according to the medical requirement, then that person would be facing the catch-up growth and they would be underweight. Then we can also say that these obese people and the underweight people are the direct victim of those people who are their peer. And normally, adolescents are those people who are making the victim by passing the negative comments. They are making fun of them, they are ridiculing them, and they would always be showing ridiculous behavior toward them, and it would be having adverse effect on their mental development and the cognitive development. We can say that who is the person who is making fun of them and who is showing this type of the negative behavior towards their peer group? Normally, there is an age group, specific age group, that is the adolescents age group. And adolescents are making the subject and victimizing their own peer group because of their obesity and their underweight. So where it is common? It is common in all the cultures, in all the societies. We cannot say that this is common in the Pakistani culture. We have observed it, that it is very much common in the American culture, it is common in the European culture, it is also common in Asian culture as well. So wherever are the adolescents and wherever are the teenagers and they are coming across in the institutions, they would be passing the negative comments. And what sort of the comments they would be passing? Oh, look at your broad shoulder. Whatever you wear, it doesn't suit you. Look at your size. You are just like a big giant. You are just like an elephant. And if there is some underweight adolescent, they would be making subject to that person by passing various negative comments. And those comments are very common everywhere. And for example, I think you are born without food. Look at your size. You are just like this animal. You are just like that. So these are the very negative comments, and it must not be passed. And those people, those adolescents who are facing this situation, who are the victims, those negative words would stick to their minds. There arise a questions by the psychologist. Does words stick to the minds? Yes, words matters a lot, and it will haunt for a longer period of time for all those adolescents who are facing these negative comments and the negative ridiculous remarks. So the person who has said those negative comments, he forget about those negative comments, but the person who is facing these things, it will haunt in his mind for a longer period of time. This will trigger his anxiety, and this will also trigger his level of stress. And later in the life, such things will be emerging into the various type of the personality disorders as well. These are the symptoms. What symptoms are there, and how the person would be feeling? The person would be feeling very low. Who is the subject? He would be feeling that maybe I am lacking something, I am deficient of something, I am deprived of something. That's why my peer are making me subject of these ridiculous remarks. The second is he would be feeling diffident. His confidence level will drop down, because this is not a one-day job. This is not a two-day victimization. This is everyday victimization. And the second thing, what body shaming victim can develop, he also may develop various type of the fear of rejection. And he don't want to leave that particular group, because he is being victimized by his own peer group. And he also think that if I will stop them, don't do body shaming or don't pass negative comments, then he may be rejected by his peer group. This is another pressure, and this pressure leads towards various type of the anxieties, and he may get the panic attacks later after facing this sort of the situation. So how to come out of this situation? There are various things. For example, Magnolia Creek, she has given a proper treatment strategy. And this treatment strategy is like all the workers, for example, the family therapist should work in this team. And she developed a team. What was the team of it? For family therapist is the one member. Then the second one is the victim. Third one is who is victimizing that particular peer group, to do his counseling as well. And the third person is the dietitian, because without the dietitian, without the proper meal schedule and without the diet plan, we cannot move ahead. The family therapist role is to do the booster session of the victim of body shaming. He would be building the confidence of that person. Like, you need to keep your morale up. Make a comparison with the rest of the people. If you don't want to leave the friendship because of the body shaming, don't leave them. Just be bold, because if you are not having any you are not having for example, if you are having some one deprivation, you would have various other characteristics and various other traits. And while doing the booster sessions, his comparison is being made, for example, that you are getting a very good position in the academics, so why you need to worry? Second is, you may excel in the fields, you can work hard, and you can show to your friends that you are a more capable person, and you can achieve your goal, and you are far more better in the various other fields who are making fun of you. Second is, they are feeling fear of rejection, and he also need to the therapist also need to give the various therapeutic sessions. Like, if you are feared that your peer group will leave you, you just don't show that you don't like their comments. If you will be showing by your gestures and the expressions, this will give them a more chance to make you subject of body shaming. Just take it easy and just relax, and never show it that you are feeling any type of the hesitation or any type of the disturbance while they are doing your body shaming. The third role is of the dietitian. And what is the role of the dietitian? Dietitian can give a proper meal plan and a proper meal schedule to all those people who are facing the body shaming. And for example, those who are overweight, with the help of the dietitian, they can get the proper meal schedule instead of eating once or twice, and with the full stomach, they need to take the frequent meals. And dietitian can give them authentic viewpoints, like how they should make the schedule of their diet and how they should make their diet plan, what things should be added in their diet and what things should not be added in their diet plan. So those diets with the full of the calories that must be excluded from the diet, and those which are containing the less calories and which is not the weight gaining, that must be included in it. This is for the obese and the overeating people who are having the big body size. And those who are nervosic, who don't eat anything, they must be given with the protein diet, and the diet which can help them to grow with the normal pace. So this is not enough. We also need to do the various counseling sessions of all those people, and we need to create the awareness that your comments can have adverse effect on your friends. And how we can do it? We need to give them awareness that if your single gesture is caused hurting, and it is developing a hurting feeling for the other person, and if you want to be liked by your friend and the peer group, and you want that everyone must appreciate you, so you should not make subject and victimize with your negative comments towards your peer group. The next thing is, another therapy can also be used, that is the experiential therapy, and this is very successful for the victims of the body shaming. If body shaming is frequently done in the institutions, this is the duty and the responsibility of the teachers and all those professors and the campus counselor to do the proper counseling of the both of the parties to avoid this ridiculous behavior of the people, because we need to change the thought and the mindset of the people, because those who are doing the body shaming, they are feeling satisfaction with it, and they are feeling more pleasure with it, and they feel so much happy. We need to change their mindset, that this mindset of teasing the other, of hurting the other, is extremely negative behavior, and we need to change your behavior, and you must not do this thing. And they must be imposed with the disciplinary actions, because they are normal people who are doing the body shaming to their peer group. They are also normal people, but we need to modify their behavior through the counseling and through various warnings. Warnings should also be given to them as well. So I hope that you people have thought about the body shaming, and we will be coming with the second episode of the body shaming, like what are the common examples of the body shaming and how they do it. Till then, Allah Hafiz.